Good morning, students. Our subject is Water Resources Engineering 1, Unit 6. Almost this is the last topic of the subject, that is General Hydrological Models regarding this Chow and Kulandai Swami Water. Kulandai Swami Model. So, actually, many type of hydrological models is there, but regarding this, Chow is one of the scientists. Kulandai Swami is the one of the scientists. Both together developed a model that is name is called a Chow Kulandai Swami model. Now we will discuss this subject in this class. So guys, this is we are using Chow and Kulandai Swami's GHS model. We are using and estimate the coefficients, estimate of coefficients. Just I want to give you a small introduction regarding this. The coefficients in the general hydrologic system GHS model of Chow and Kulandai Swami 1971 are estimated using the method of cumulants. Based on this method, a rational criterion is developed to determine the number of terms to be retained in the GHS model. The least squares method used by Chow and Kulandai Swami 1971 and the method of cumulatives proposed here are compared and are found to yield comparable values of the model coefficients on an example watershed. Guys, introduction. The so-called General Hydrologic System GHS model Kulandai Swami 1964, Chow 1964 and Dogi 1973 developed by Chow and Kulandai Swami has been utilized in several studies dealing with the watershed runoff modeling and flood routing in open channels. The GHS model hypothesizes that the storage S in the watershed can be expressed as a linear sum of surface runoff Q and rainfall excess I and their time derivatives, that is equal to S is equal sigma I is equal 0 to m AI is equal DA Q by DT square plus sigma J is equal 0 to n BJ DJ I by DT J, where AI and BI are coefficients as functions of Q and I, m and n are finite non-negative integer numbers with m greater than n equation when coupled with the special lumped from a continuity equation ds by dt is equal to I minus q. Together with the initial conditions, q of 0 is equal to d square q of 0 by dt square is equal to 0, I is equal to 0, 1, 2 and m constitutes the GHS model. Q plus I is equal to 0 to M, AI D to the power of I plus 1 by DT square plus 1. That is equal to I minus J is equal to 0 to N, BJ D to the power of J plus 1 by DTJ+1 of practical expediency Chow and Kulandai Swami, Kulandai Swami introduced to simplifications in equation 4. The coefficients AI and BI are constants, are only functions of some characteristic of Q and I, such as mean or maximum. In this study, we will consider them to be constant, M and N equal 2 and 1 respectively. This choice was based on fitting various forms of equation 4 to observe watershed runoff data. They reported that higher derivatives of I and Q were insignificant for the cases which they studied and could therefore be ignored without causing appreciable error in model results. Thus, the GHS model reduces to Q plus J naught dQ by dt plus AI d square Q by dt square plus A2 d3Q by dt square, that is equal I minus B naught dI by dt minus B1 d square I by dt square. In fitting equation to observed runoff data, Chow and Kulandai Swami used the least squares method to determine the coefficients AI and BJ. This implies that the coefficients will depend on how accurately the derivatives of I and Q can be determined, given I in a histogram from the accuracy of its derivatives is doubtful. Given skewed shape of Q, its derivatives can hardly be determined accurately. Connett 1965. It may therefore be desirable to develop a method to estimate AI and BJ which is independent of the derivatives of I and Q. This study proposes the method of cumulants which satisfies this requirement. It may be remarked that this method offers an explanation for determining M and N. Utilizing rainfall runoff observations from a small agriculture watershed, the model coefficients are determined for M is equal to 1 by the method of cumulants and are compared with those determined by the least squares method. Simplification of equation 4. Chow and Kulandai Swami and Chow and Kulandai Swami derived the instantaneous unit hydrographs IUH for various cases depending upon the roots of the equation A2xq plus A1x square plus A0x plus 1 is equal to 0. The use of instantaneous unit hydro. Just wait, guys. Instantaneous unit hydrograph is consistent because AI and BJ are constant in equation 5 is linear. There is, however, an inconsistency in their derivation, recognition of which simplifies equations 4 and 5 considerably, as discussed by Sine and McCann. For an IUH, rainfall excess is represented by delta function delta t. If an impulse of rainfall excess delta t takes place uniformly over the entire watershed, then it is natural to assume that the IUH will be zero at t is equal to zero and will experience rise and fall with the progress of time. Sine and McCann, 1980, have proved that in order for this to be true and equation 5 to have a unique solution, where I is delta t, the coefficients b naught and bi must vanish. Therefore, equation 4 reduces u plus I is equal to 0 to sigma m, ai is equal to di plus 1 by u by d to I by I plus 1, that is equal to sigma t. Equation 5 to u plus a naught du by dt plus a1 into d square u by dt square plus a2 du cube by dt cube, that is equal to delta t. And the initial condition in equation 3 to u of 0 is equal d power I plus 1 into u by dt to the power of I plus 1 naught is equal to 0. I is equal to 0, 1 to m, where u is the IUH. Thus, it is seen that u will be independent of vi. Thus, it is seen that u will be independent of bj. Chow and Kulandaiswamy incorrectly complicated their model. Runoff q can be determined by convolution of u with I. Q of t is equal to 0 to the power of t is equal to u to the power of t minus j t minus t I into t of dt, where t star is equal to t for t greater than t, less than t, duration of I, and t naught is equal to t plus t less than or equal to greater than or equal to t. Mathematical solutions. We can solve equation 6 subject to the initial condition in equation 8 for some special cases using the Laplace transform. Let the Laplace transform of u be defined as y of s is equal to 0 to 8 sigma e to the power of minus st u of t into dt. Then, thinking the Laplace transformation equation 6 subject to equation 8. Here, guys, this is the equation 11. Hence, mu of t is the inverse Laplace transform of here, when is equal to m is equal to 0, when m is equal to 1. Guys, here, equation you observe, equation 12, equation 13, equation 14, and equation 15, and equation 16. Here, where from equation 15, where a, b, c are the roots of g of x is equal to a2x cube plus a1x square plus a0x plus 1. Similarly, we can solve equation 6 for m is equal to 3, 4, and so on. Though with increasing complexity, in general, it is difficult to determine the inverse Laplace transform of equation 11. But this is not needed from a practical standpoint point, as noted by Chow and Kundalaiswamy. A method of cumulatives to determine coefficient AI. The coefficients AI in equation 6 can be estimated using either moments or cumulants. A distinct advantage of cumulative is that they expect, except for the first, remain unaffected by the change of origin. We therefore resorted to the use of cumulants. The rth cumulant of IUH U can be defined as equation 17. substituting equation 11 in equation 17, then the notion Sn is equal to 0 means that the associated quantity to be evaluated at the S is equal to 0, equation 18 is K1 is equal to A naught, K2 is equal to A naught square by minus 2A1, K3 is equal to A, 2A naught 3 minus 6A0 A1 plus 6A2 and so on. Km function of A naught, A1, A2 and so on, A minus 1. Hence equation 19 yields A is equal to K1, A1 is equal to 1 by 2, K1 2 minus K2, A2 is equal to 1 by 16, K3 plus K1 3 minus 1 by 2, K1, K2 and so on. Am is equal to function of K1, K2, K3 and Km plus 1. The cumulants K1, K2, K3 of U can be determined from rainfall excess runoff data using the theorem of cumulants for linear time invariant hydrologic systems, DOG 1973. Thus, it can be seen from equation that the coefficient AI can be determined without using derivatives of Q. This advantage coupled with simplicity of computation might make the method of cumulants more attractive and preferable in some cases than the least squares method as used by Chow and Kundaleswamy. A method of computing cumulant for a given set of data is discussed in the appendix. The compare these two methods, A0 and A1, for the case M is equal to 1, where computed for 6 rainfall excess runoff events from watershed SW is equal to 17. Reisel, Waxer, Texas, the shown in table 1, the two methods yielded comparable values of the coefficients. Guys, this is the table 1 estimation of the coefficients A0 and A1 for the case M1 using the last squares method and the method of cumulants for some rainfall excess runoff events on watershed as well. So guys, this is the so units used in computation were centimeters per hour. Criterion for determination of M. Equation 20 shows that the coefficients AI are functions of the cumulants. Since cumulants, especially higher order, are sensitivity to small changes in the function, we expect the coefficient AI to be sensitivity to small errors in the rainfall excess runoff data. Therefore, choosing M higher than 2 does not usually increase the accuracy of the model. In fact, a very high value of M may lead to entirely unrealistic results due to unreliable estimates of the coefficients. Moreover, it can be shown that if, more example, the second order equation M is equal to 1 accurately represent the system, then the coefficients A2, A3, AM in equation 20 will all be zero. Similarly, if the third order equation accurately represents the system, then the coefficients A3, A4, AM in equation 20 will all be zero, and so on. To illustrate, if M is equal to 1, then a short calculation shows that A2, the leading coefficient of the third order equation, vanishes. That is 1 by 6 K3 plus K1 3 minus 1 by 2 K1 K2 is equal to 0. Similar calculations can be carried out for third and higher order systems. It then follows that if the second order equation closely approximates the system, small errors in measuring the data may be relatively large compared to E2. The leading coefficient of the third order equation, this coupled with the observation that sensitivity is related to the sensitivity of the cumulants, suggests that M is equal to 1 is the best choice for M in this case. These observations on the choice of M also help to cumulants to estimate coefficients in GHS model. This figure comparison of observed surface runoff hydrograph with the hydrograph computed by method of moments and the least squares method for rainfall runoff event of 6/24/1959 and watershed in Texas. And here, explain the occurrence of complex roots and oscillations in the results of Chow and Kulandeswamy 1971. Thus, a rational criterion for determining M consists in A, sensitivity of cumulants, and B, relative magnitudes of the coefficients Ai. If these coefficients are accurately determined, then it would normally follow that Ai greater than Ai plus 1, I is equal to 0, 1, 2, and so on M. If the value of AM is very small relative to AM minus 1 for specified M, then this value of M may usually be appropriate. Our experience coupled with those observations suggests that on most watersheds, M equal to 1 or at most 2 will be satisfactory for the GHS model. To illustrate the GHS model with M is equal to 1, was utilized to generate surface runoff hydrographs for the rainfall runoff events of watershed SW17. So Texas reported in table 1. In each case, it was found that important hydrograph characteristics were adequately reproduced as shown in sample figure 1-2. Thus, the second order system may be acceptable from a practical standpoint. This is the comparison of observed surface runoff hydrograph with a hydrograph computed by methods of moments and least squares method for rainfall runoff event of on watershed in Texas. And conclusions, guys. The following conclusions are drawn from this study. The method of cumulants yield values of the model coefficients comparable to those of the least squares method for a natural watershed study here. The method of cumulants is simple and free of derivatives of rainfall excess and runoff. The least squares method may be unreliable whenever the derivatives of runoff are not estimated accurately. Based on the method of cumulants, a rational criterion is developed to determine M in the GHS model. The observations made in this study support the values of M reached empirically by Kulandeswamy 1964 and Chow and Kulandeswamy 1971. Thank you guys. Within this topic, we completed water resource engineering 1 subject successfully. Thank you guys, all of your patience. Thank you very much.